It's my third day in Lyon. I've been really lazy, catching up on sleep and editing. Today I'm going out to be a tourist. So it's actually midday already, so I'm kind of leaving the house a bit late. But one nice thing about being in Lyon is that most things appear to be open really late. So most of the museums seem to be open till about 6 o'clock. And one of the cathedrals says 10 on like a Friday, I think. So that seems quite good because I don't do mornings. I do mornings, but not if I can help it. So I am just walking down to the metro station and I'm going to see if I can get to, I think there's a cathedral called the Cathedral de Notre-Dame, which looks quite amazing. And also a museum of fine art. So I'm just gonna go and see if I can find those. Yeah, I mean, it looks pretty straightforward. The metro system seems to run on about 4 different lines and they're all sort of lettered A, B, C, D. And everything looks quite clearly labeled. You can also get a ticket for a day or a ticket for 2 days just to go around the city. It's unlimited travel, which seems like a really great idea. So let's go and see if I can pick up one of those. Okay, so I remember from arriving that this isn't touch screen. You need to use these things here. So first, I just need to change the language to English. And then I am rolling this screen thing to choose what I want. Now it's cheaper to get a 48-hour ticket, but I'm not very good at doing 2 days on the road in a trot. So I think I'm just gonna buy a 1 day ticket today, and that's unlimited travel for 24 hours. So that should be perfect for what I need today. So green button to confirm. 1 ticket, confirm. And put my card in. Okay, I was going to say that was super easy, but I've either got a card that doesn't work or I've accidentally bought 2 of them. Because I got the first one and it says abandon, and it said please remove your credit card. So I thought it didn't work. So I did it again. And Google Translate doesn't say anything about it having been like rejected. So I think I've just accidentally bought 2 24-hour travel cards. So let me just go and see if it works. If it goes through the machine, it's worked. And if it doesn't go through the machine, I need to try and buy a ticket again. So I'm already a bit confused. See what happens. Oh, I just dropped it. Oh. Maybe it's this. No, I guess maybe I like it hasn't worked. I'm really scared to go into these ones because I think if you go in and your card doesn't work, I think maybe you get trapped in there. I'm not too sure. So, Let's try this machine again. Okay, success. The other machine wasn't working, but I have now managed to put my card through a different machine and I think we're good to go. Hooray!
Lyon's metro system is incredibly easy to navigate once you've bought a ticket. And the ticket works on the metro, buses and trams, which I think is fantastic value. I had to cut the sound here because music was playing over the tannoy and I didn't want to get a copyright strike. But I descended to the platform to the catchy beat of Barefooting by Wilson Pickett. It certainly put a spring in everyone's step. I took the A line from Cusset to Bellecour, and then one stop on the D line to Vieux-Lyon, which is where things got far more fun. From this point, you need to take the funicular railway up to the top of the hill where the basilica sits. A funicular railway is a type of railway carriage that goes up the side of a steep hill or mountain. There's usually 2 carts that counterweight each other, so as one comes down, the other goes up and they pass in the middle. I haven't been on one of these since I was a kid. They were really easy to find. As you exit the station, follow the F sign for funicular. I like the way the passengers get off one side and on the other. inside the carriage were rainbow trippy. Très génial. Here's the other carriage coming down. Stepping out of the station, you immediately come face to face with a huge cathedral. But nothing could prepare me for the inside. This is the Basilica of Our Lady of Fourvière. It looks ancient, but was completed in the 1880s. The site was once a Roman forum, and a small chapel was built on top of it in 1168, first dedicated to St. Thomas and then to the Virgin Mary. Today, the Basilica is still dedicated to the worship of the Virgin Mary, making it a Marian church and the city of Lyon a Marian city, which is the name given to places dedicated to her worship. This adherence to Mary can be seen in the iconography and in the colours blue and gold that prevail throughout the upper church. It is, hands down, without equal, the most beautiful church I have ever seen, though it raises some deeply uncomfortable questions. The Catholic Church has always been particularly good at using ritual and dazzling displays of wealth to inspire awe in its parishioners. But gazing upon this ostentatious display, it's easy to imagine how it might backfire, giving birth to Protestantism and a desire for reform. Imagine being poor and hungry, and having to bend your knee to God in such a place as this. Would you be more likely to feel thankful or resentful? It's hard to say for someone like myself, who is not Christian, but from an outside perspective, it does seem somewhat problematic. These images really don't do it justice. The lighting in the cathedral and the shimmering iridescent gold is absolutely breathtaking. I highly recommend a visit. Beneath the main church is a lower church. It's called the crypt, but it's actually a second level dedicated to Joseph as Jesus' adoptive father. On the way downstairs, the prayer Hail Mary is written in every language, including Kinyarwanda. There are several statues of Mary in the lower church, many of them the Black Madonna. This is Our Lady of Africa. This is Joseph holding baby Jesus.
Hi guys, so I've just found these clouty trees, and you see these in Ireland, they're very common. Armenia, they're very common. They're usually near water, and people tie ribbons to them to take away sickness or as prayers. Perhaps the different colours signify different prayers here. In Armenia, different knots mean different prayers, so it's kind of interesting to see them here, but not next to a well or a stream. These are a very ancient pagan tradition. I'm in a very happy place because I heard that there was a really incredible view up here, and I was assuming that I'd have to climb one of the big towers to go and look out across the city, but I don't. It's literally right behind me here. You just rock up, go behind the church, and there's a view of the city. Let's go take a look.
Lyon is the third largest city in France and the second most populated. It was the capital of the Celtic Gauls during the Roman Empire, and it's the birthplace of cinematography, as it was home to the Lumiere brothers, who developed cinematic cameras at the end of the 19th century. My host said that it's starting to gain a reputation for tourism, whereas before many people stuck to the well-trod tourist regions of Paris and Marseille, now they're starting to explore Lyon. And it's easy to see why.
Well, that was pretty damn spectacular. I had no idea that Lyon was, quite so incredibly beautiful. We've got a lovely day for it. The sun is out. It really feels like spring. I was worried I was going to freeze to death, but I'm actually absolutely fine. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the funicular railway back down again, because as I was waiting to come up here, I noticed that the funicular railway next to me was going to a Roman amphitheatre. So I'm going to see if I can hop on that and go and see the ancient Roman theatre. Thank you.
What are you doing today, Marion? Oh, just hanging out at the ancient Roman amphitheatre because, hey, why not? This is just a bit nuts. It really is. So easy to get around the city. And literally 15 minutes ago, I was in a cathedral full of gold. And now I'm standing at an ancient Roman theatre. So I'm liking Lyon a lot. Okay, we're going up here. I think we're going up here. And I didn't even fast forward that. Wow. That's a pretty impressive place to have a theatre. Looking right out across the city. Looks like they're setting up for a show down there. It's amazing that something that is, you know, so, so old is still in use today. It's fantastic. The Romans originally created a settlement for war refugees in 43 AD, establishing a presence on Fourvière Hill, which was then called Lugdunum, which is likely from the Gaulish Lu Odunnan, hill fort of the Celtic sun god Lu. The Roman emperors Claudius and Caracalla were both born here. The city passed from the hands of the Holy Roman Empire to France during the 14th century. I'm just here at the amphitheatre. I'm stunned. I mean, Lyon is not a city I would ever have thought to come and visit if it wasn't on my way to somewhere else. And I'm so glad I haven't missed it. This is really incredible. I can't believe how easy it is to get around the city. It's only about €6-7 for a 24-hour unlimited travel pass, which I think is fantastic. There's funicular railways, putting the fun back in railways. Wah, wah, wah. And it's just fantastic. And look, I've got out of my proper big coat. I'm in my like thin jacket at the moment because it is actually nice and warm. It's feeling a little bit springtime at the moment. So there's a little cafe down there and I'm going to go get a cup of tea and something to eat and decide what to do next. I think I'm probably going to head to the Fine Art Museum if I can find it. So let's go and see. I have no real plans, and because of that I've ended up here at the amphitheatre, which I didn't realise was so close to the cathedral. So yeah, let's go and get something to eat and go and see some more of the city. Ah, I can see the cathedral from here. I think that's where we were before, possibly. Thank you.
a little refreshment van just next to the entrance, and I decided to grab a bite to eat.
Hi guys, I know this is going to sound like a total cop-out, but I've just had such a nice day. It's only about 4 o'clock, but I'm going to head home now because the cathedral was stunning. The amphitheatre was just joyful. I just sat there for sort of ages. I must have been there for about 40 minutes, just sitting, enjoying sitting there, looking at the people sitting there. So it's just been such a nice afternoon, and I had a sandwich and a drink. So I think I'm just going to head home now. My ticket is valid for 24 hours. So I could keep hold of it and use it tomorrow because I want to go and see the Fine Art Museum. But by the time I get there, if it's closing around 6 o'clock, I'm not really going to get to see everything that I want to see. So I think I'm just going to go tomorrow morning. So I could use this still to get there tomorrow morning, but I think I might just try and give it to somebody on the way home, because even if I use it to get there in the morning, by the afternoon I'm going to need another ticket anyway. But yeah, I've had such a lovely day. I think I just want to enjoy the fact that I've had a lovely day, go home, put my feet up, watch some Netflix, and tomorrow maybe go and find something else to look at. So yeah. Okay, so I went to take the funicular railway and I got onto the wrong platform and it was going up the hill instead of back down the hill. So I thought I'd get on it and just see where it goes. So I'm not entirely sure where I am, but I'm just walking down the back streets and taking a little look around. It just looks like a little suburb. So why not? I'll go for a quick walk around the block and then I'll head back to the station and then I'll head home. Seeing these signs to somewhere called Saint Arine, and I imagine that's a church, and I'm just curious, so I'm going to keep following the signs until I find it. This looks promising. Or do we carry on where the signpost says St. Irene's Church? I'm going this way. Why take the main road when you can take the back streets? I think that might be it. Found this beautiful little community garden. So it doesn't look like there's any way inside the church, but there's a very old looking crypt. I don't think it's open to tourists. still, at least we know. I think I'm going to head back to the railway. So that's the road I came up, but that sign next to it, I guess that kind of means no through for walking? I'm not sure. But I just came up it. Does it mean I can't walk down it, or does it mean walking only? I'm going to be naughty. I think I'm going to do it. It's the quickest way back. I made it, and nothing bad happened. Swung home past the local shop and picked up a couple of beers. I like Leff and I know Brune and Blonde, but I don't know Ruby Leff, so I'm going to give that a go. But I'm going to begin with Grimbergen because it's a blonde and I feel like something thirst quenching.